Manjaro is well pre-configured by default, but there are still things you can do to improve your user experience. These are my 10 things to do after installing Manjaro Linux. I applied these 10 things in my Manjaro with Plasma 5 desktop, which I reviewed here. But do not close this video, all these tips will also work for Xfce and GNOME desktops. Let's get started. And the first thing I recommend to do is to install Pamac. Pamac is much better software manager than Octopi. Let's open Octopi, search for Pamac, and install it. Now let's open Pamac. So this is how it looks, and it was recommended by one of my subscribers, who said it was much better than Octopi. And after trying Pamac, I can completely agree. For example, if we go to the preferences, you will need to enter your administrative password to enter the preferences. You will see that it is a little more advanced than Octopi. For example, here you can easily enable Arch user repository, and you don't need to install any AUR helpers, as you have to do for Octopi. I showed how to enable AUR in Octopi in this video. There are also some other useful settings. For example, you can clean cache from here, and you can also define how many versions of a cached package you want to keep on your system. You can also refresh mirror list here. Usually you can do it for Pacman manually through the command line, but it is very easily to be done here. You just need to find your country here, select it, and click refresh mirror list. Depending on your country, it may take quite a while, but after that the mirror list will be refreshed and Pamac will download the packages from the fastest mirror in your country, which will make the installation process of packages through Pamac much faster. You can also check the general settings here. For example, I really like these settings that you can remove unrequired dependencies. You can also define how often you want to check for updates, and some other settings like to download automatic updates and hide icon when updates are not available, which is very useful. I will enable this option. And if you want to use only Pamac, you can remove Octopi. And remove all the installed packages associated with Octopi. By default, when your Manjaro boots, you see this boot menu. You either need to press enter, or you need to wait some time until the system starts booting. But you can disable it and boot into your Manjaro system as fast as possible. Open the terminal and edit the file atc defult group. Enter your password, and here you can see group timeout. It is set to 5 seconds by default, but you can set it to 0. This way your system will boot much faster. Ctrl O to save the file, and Ctrl X to exit from nano editor. When the group settings are changed, you need to update your group. Run sudo update-grub. If you reboot your system, now there is no delay with group menu, and Manjaro boots few seconds faster. If you don't like these settings, you can go back to the group settings and change group timeout back to 5 seconds. Don't forget to upgrade group after you change its settings. Number 3. Reduce swappiness. By default, when Manjaro uses a lot of RAM memory, it starts writing some files into your hard drive, and the hard drive is usually slower than the RAM memory. But if you have more than 2 GB of RAM, you can use this RAM memory more efficient. And to do that, you need to change your swappiness value. You can check the default swappiness by running this command get proc sys vm.swappiness. And the default value will be 60. To reduce this value, you need to create a file atc sysctl.d 100 manjaro.conf. Enter your password and write here vm.swappiness equal 10. Save the file with Ctrl O and press Ctrl X to exit. Now reboot your system and check the swappiness value again. It is 10 now. So this way Manjaro will use your RAM memory more efficient. Number 4, install and enable Firewall. I was surprised Manjaro doesn't have any graphical program to manage Firewall. So let's install it. Open Pamac or Octopi if you still prefer to use Octopi and search for gufw and install it. Open it from your menu. Enter your password. And if you see it doesn't open, this is because there is a small bug with this program, but you can easily fix it. If you open the terminal and try to run this program from the terminal, and you will see this error message. Don't worry, it can be easily fixed if you edit one of the gufw file. Run sudo, use editor nano, and edit file bin gufw. Enter your password, and here you need to add this line of text. KDE su, this is if you use KDE. If you use GNOME or Xfce, you need to use the command gksudo. So again, if you use KDE, use this command. If you use Xfce or GNOME, you should use gksudo. I run KDE here, so I will proceed with this command. And next type python3 usr lib python 3.7. Don't worry, I will also provide this command in the description of this video, so you can just copy paste it in your Manjaro. Site packages gufw gufw.py. Ctrl O to save and Ctrl X to exit. If I execute this command again, now as you can see, gufw opens. And to make sure it works from your menu, we can close it here and open again. So as you can see, the problem has been fixed, and now you can use the graphical interface to manage your firewall. Usually, I would just enable it and use the default settings. Here you can choose different profiles. If it's your home, you can use home profile. If it's public or office, you can use either of these two profiles. I will keep it home. This is a very easy program to manage your firewall. For example, you can open some ports here if you want. It's also very user-friendly here. Just find application for which you want to open a firewall and enable it. But I think for most of the users, simple default settings as they are now will work fine. If you are a little unhappy or uncomfortable working with this firewall program, you can also watch my things to do after installing Arch Linux, where I showed how to enable the command line interface of UFW. But I think Manjaro users will prefer a graphical program, so that's why I recommend using gufw. Number 5, spell checking. Manjaro has some spell checking programs installed by default, and it works pretty fine. But if you do a lot of writing, as I do, you can extend the functionality of spell checking programs with libmythes and language tools. These programs will assist you with your writings. So, simply run the command sudo pacman with option s and paste the names of these programs. Again, I also copy them in the description. So, click enter. Now, your writing process in Manjaro will be a little bit more advanced because you can benefit from using all these packages for spell checking, methods, and grammar checking. Number 6, install Microsoft fonts. I think installing Microsoft fonts is essential, because if you need to open a document which was sent to you by somebody who is using Microsoft products, most likely that document will use Microsoft fonts, so it is good to install it. Open Pamac Package Manager and search for the package ttf ms fonts. This is where the Arch user repository becomes handy. As you can see, you can install this package from the AUR repository, mark it for installation, and apply. You can see the details of the building and installing process in this detail tab. This is one more reason why I like Pamac. It has very nice interface. So make sure there are no errors in this terminal window and that everything is installed successfully. So when the Microsoft fonts are installed, you can close Pamac and open LibreOffice to check if the Microsoft fonts are available. And as you can see, here is Times New Roman, or if you scroll to the very top, you will see Arial, which are the most popular Microsoft fonts. You can use them in your LibreOffice to create and read documents. Number 7. Enable trim for SSD. By default, Manjaro will work pretty fine with your SSD drive, but you can still extend the lifespan of your SSD if you enable trim, which is disabled by default. And to enable it, you need to go to the terminal and run this simple command: sudo systemctl enable fstrim.timer and press enter. You should see a message that a symlink has been created, and this means that fstrim is enabled in your system after you reboot it. This will extend the lifespan of your SSD drive. But if you don't use SSD, you can skip this step. Number 8. Remove orphan packages. When you install and remove different packages, sometimes there are some packages which remain on your system, but they are not used by any program. So these are the orphan packages. And usually you can remove them to keep your system clean. If you open Pamac and go to the installed category, you will see also the category orphans. You can click on it, and if you see any package here, you can remove it because it is an orphan package. But be careful, because sometimes some packages may be recognized as orphan packages, but you still may want to use them for some reasons. Unfortunately, I don't have any orphan package on my system right now, so I cannot show you any. But I think it is good if you know about this option. Number 9. Check for errors. It is also good to check for errors in your Manjaro system from time to time. For example, you can check for any failed systemd processes. To do that, you need to run the command sudo systemctl this option failed. And if you see a message like this one, which says 0, it means there is no failed processes, which is very good. If you see that some processes failed here, try to find the way how to fix them. The easiest would be just to Google the error message. In addition to failed systemd processes, you can also check if there are any errors in your log files. And to that end, you run command sudo journalctl with option p3 and xb. It is very likely you will see some errors here, but it doesn't mean these errors are very critical. Just have a look what they mean. If you recognize some of them and you think it is important, try to fix them. If you are unsure about some error messages, Google them and also try to fix them. So as you can see here, I have some core dump processes here, which is not very good probably. But it is my test system, so it is not very critical for me, and I'm not going to use Manjaro as my daily driver. I installed this distribution to review it for you and to create this video for you, so I'm not going to investigate these issues. And to exit from these error messages, you need to press letter Q and you are back to your terminal. So if you're unsure about some error messages, if everything works fine, don't worry. But if you want your system to work perfectly, investigate what you have here, and if it's needed, fix these errors. And the last thing to do after installing Manjaro is to backup your system. Actually, I was pretty surprised that I was not able to find any backup graphical program installed in Manjaro by default. So that's why I recommend you to open Package Manager and search for different backup programs. There are different choices here. I have a specific playlist about how to do backup in Linux. You can watch it here and pick the program you like the most. For example, I think Manjaro users will find pretty useful grsync program because it is a graphical program of rsync. Rsync is probably the most popular backup tool, but it is still a little complicated, so if you are a complete newbie, I think Dejadup backup tool will work the best because it is a backup program which is installed by default in Ubuntu. It is pretty user-friendly and it is very simple. So I recommend you to go with this program. If you want some advanced features, you can also go with grsync. But let's install Dejadup backup tool. It is installed now, let's open it. Here it is. It is a pretty simple program. You can backup your system and your data files, as well as you can restore them. If you go through all these settings, they are also pretty intuitive, I believe. Here you can define where you want to backup. I really like this program because you can use some of the cloud storage here. For example, if you have Google Drive, you can enable and use it to backup your system there. You can also backup through the network, and probably my favorite option, and this is what I recommend to most users, is to backup to an external USB drive. They are pretty cheap now, so you can buy an external USB drive, connect to your system, and backup to that USB drive. When you connect it to your system, you just click here and select it. Here I'm on the devices. I don't have any USB drive connected right now. And if you want, you can also schedule backups. But for this, you need to have your external USB drive connected permanently to your system, or you need to use any cloud storage. So, I recommend you to go with this backup tool because it is very, very user-friendly. Or, I don't know, if you are a Manjaro user, what backup tool do you use and what would you recommend to other Manjaro users? Please leave a comment below, and thank you for watching.